Proficient in covert operations, Orc Commandos are experts at stealthy assassinations, explosive sabotage, and Orcish subterfuge. Welcome to this painting video, where I'm going to show you how to paint your Orc Commandos up to battle-ready standard. I'm going to use really easy-to-follow tips and techniques, so you can have your Orcs behind enemy lines causing havoc in no time at all. Now, in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to paint an Orc Commando knob, but of course, all the techniques I'm going to show you here can be applied to other members of the squad as well. I've already undercoated the model here with Mechanicus Standard Grey Spray, as it's the perfect colour to use as an undercoat for all the colours I'm going to paint over the top. Now, first of all, let's have a look at painting that famous Orc green skin. And for this, of course, I'm using Auric Flesh. Grab your small base brush for this. Let's take some Auric Flesh here from the pot and apply it to my palette like so. Now, with a base paint like this, it's always a good idea to add a little bit of water in from my pot here and mix it in on the palette to help thin that paint down. It means it goes on really smooth. Then, once I've loaded the brush up, it's time to grab my Orc, and here I'm painting this all over the skin like so. There's quite a lot of flesh on Orc Commando, so just make sure you're picking it all out. Now, as it's going on, you'll see straight away, I'll need a second coat to get a nice solid base coat of Auric Flesh all over. So let the first coat dry, then apply a second coat over the top. Try and be as neat as you possibly can, and make sure you hit all the areas of flesh. There's quite a few showing through these various straps and jerkins and things. So, after a couple of coats, we've got a nice solid base coat of Auric Flesh. Now, let's add some more detail to that skin by adding a contrast paint over the top, and naturally, I'm using Orc Flesh. I'm going to mix it a little here with contrast medium to help thin that paint down to make the effect on the muscles nice and subtle. Grab your medium shade brush. Here, take one brushful of Orc Flesh and apply it to your palette like so. Then, we'll wash our brush off to make sure there's absolutely no paint left on there at all, and then wipe our brush off with a piece of tissue paper just to make sure it's nice and clean. Then I'll take two brushfuls of contrast medium here and apply it to my palette like so, and mix them all together like this to create a nice thinned down Orc Flesh. Then we'll load the brush up like so, and onto the Orc, here we're applying it all over the skin like this, a nice even coat of this paint all over my Orc's flesh, and you'll see straight away it's having that really cool effect on the skin, falling into all the recesses, giving that really cool shade effect. Apply this all over our Orc's skin like so, and once that's dry we'll move on to the next stage. The Orc Flesh contrast paint has dried, and look at the effect it's had on the skin. A really cool subtle shading effect there, and all the details picked out too. Now, let's add some more base coats to my Orc Commando knob here, and we'll start off by applying Castellan Green onto his olive drab jacket. Then some Abaddon Black will be painted onto the boots, the hat, and some other areas of the model as well, like the backpack. I'll take some Rhinox Hide and pick out his combat trousers, and then take some Steel Legion Drab to pick out some of the leather. Now, first of all, is that Castellan Green, and here again I've got my small base brush. So, let's take some Castellan Green here from the pot, and just like before, I'll take a little bit of water to thin it down to make sure it goes on real smooth. Then onto my Orc Commando, and here I'm painting it like so all over the jacket like this, this olive drab jacket, to get a nice coverage here. Here we're being super careful not to hit any of the skin we've already painted, so try and be as neat as you possibly can here. If you do hit the skin, you can always go back and repaint it if you need to, but just try and take your time and be as neat as possible. Next up, it's Abaddon Black, and here I'm using it to paint the hat, the backpack, and the boots, or any other areas you want to be black as well. Again, just be as neat as you possibly can here, just pick out all those areas you want to be black. Next up, it's Rhinox Hide, and here I'm using it to paint his trousers. So again, here it's being super careful not to hit any of the other areas we already painted. Get a nice solid base coat of Rhinox Hide all over his combat trousers. For the next base coat, I've got Steel Legion Drab, and here I'm using a small airbrush to pick out various parts of leather on my Orc Commando, such as these straps going around his body like this, the belt, and other bits of leather on the model as well. That's the Steel Legion Drab done, and you can see I've also painted the bricks on the base that colour as well. Now, up next, let's have a look at painting the metal on our commando. And here I'm going to start off by painting all the metal areas with Iron Warriors first. That's the dark base coat metal colour. Once that's done, I'll then pick out some areas with Iron Hand Steel and other areas with Balthazar Gold to help break up those metal areas. First of all, Iron Warriors. Here again, grab your small base brush. Let's take some Iron Warriors here from the pot and apply it to our palette. Now here, I'll use a little bit of water, just not too much for metallic paint, to help thin that down. Then, load the brush up and onto my Orc. Here I'm painting all the areas that are going to be metallic in the end. So I'm going to paint the entire power claw here with iron warriors like this. All the wires, the grenades, the gun, everything's going to be metal this colour. And later on, I'll pick out various areas with other colours to help break it up. Next up, I've got some iron hand steel. Now here I'm picking out some areas of metal, and there's no real uniform or rhyme or reason here. It's just different parts of the metal I want to be slightly lighter than the iron warriors. So here, for example, I'm picking out the claws themselves on the power claw. Maybe I'll pick out different parts of the gun as well, like the barrel here. What I'm looking to do here is simply break up the metal here and make it look a bit more exciting than one colour. Next up, I've got Balthazar gold, and here again, I'm using it to break up those metal areas. So perhaps a picker, a little bit out here on the power claw, maybe a bit on the shooter as well. It's entirely up to you which parts you pick out with this colour, but it just helps break up all the metal areas to make it look like one big metal lump. So there we go, we've broken up all those metal areas using the three different tones of metal. So the shooter, the dish on the back, the stick bomb, and of course the claw as well. Got lots of nice cool metal tones going on there. Alright, up next let's finish off the base coats with first a base coat of Wordbearer's Red, which we're going to place onto the glyph plates. Then we'll take some Rakarth flesh and paint it onto the glyphs themselves, as well as the teeth on our orc knob and any other cloth on the model as well. Now first of all is that Wordbearer's Red. Here I've got my small layer brush out again. Let's take some Wordbearer's Red here and apply it to our palette here like so. We don't need too much paint here, it's only small areas we're painting. Then a touch of water here as always. Perfect. Keep a nice point on that brush. Then onto our orc, and here we're painting this onto two different areas. We've got the orc's glyph plate down here at the bottom on his belt, and I'm also going to paint the glyph plate on the gun here as well. That's the Wordbearer's Red applied. I've also applied it to this wire around the back here to help break up those darker colours. And up next is Rakarth Flesh. Here I'm applying this to the glyphs on the model. I'll also paint my orc's teeth too, and there's a bedroll at the back here, so I'll paint that in now too as well. So there we go, that's all the base coat applied to my Orc Commando knob. Now up next, before I apply any washes, I'm going to put the base paint onto the base right now. It's a texture paint called Agrellan Earth to make it look like my Orc Commando knob is sneaking his way around the desert. Now to apply this, I'm going to be using my medium base brush. So let's do that now. Let's take some Agrellan Earth from the pot here. Like so, I'm going to load the brush up quite a bit here with quite a lot of the paint. I'm not using the palette really. There we go, got quite a lot of paint on the brush. Then onto the base of my orc knob. Here what I'm doing is applying this all over the top like so. I'm going to be putting it on quite thickly here, as the more you apply, the better and more pronounced the crackle effect will be. So just putting it all over the top of the base like so. Just making sure we're not hitting the feet of the orc or the wall. Here we go, nice and neat like so. Well, put this all over the top like this, and then allow about an hour for it to fully dry. And once it has, you'll see a really cool crackle effect all over the base too. Well, the Agrellan Earth has dried, giving this really cool crackle effect all over our base. Now, up next, let's take a wash, Agrax Earthshade, and apply it to all the areas we've just painted, all those base coats and the base as well, but crucially, not the flesh. This will give us some really cool definition and add extra detail as well. Grab your medium shade brush for this. Let's take some Agrax Earthshade from the pot here and apply it to my palette. Now, I'm going to be using quite a bit here, so I'll take quite a bit out. Then, load my brush up like this. Perfect. Onto my orc. Here we go. What we're doing here is applying this Agrax Earthshade over all those areas we painted. So the greens, the browns, the metals, the reds, the black, even the base and the bricks too. Literally every part of the model apart from the flesh. Don't paint the flesh here. We don't want it to go brown. So just make sure we're keeping that flesh nice and clean and painting the rest of the miniature with this Agrax Earthshade wash. So there we go, the Agrax Earthshade has dried all over our Orc Commando knob, and just look at the effect it's had on all those areas. Lots of cool shading, lots of details picked out, and the whole thing looks a little bit grimier, which is perfect. Now, this is one paint left to use here, that's Steganon Scale Green. I'm going to use this to pick out the lenses on the model, any screens, and also our Orc Commando knob's fingernails. Now for this, as they're all small details, I'm using my small layer brush. Let's take some Steganon Scale Green here from the pot. I'm actually not going to use the palette here at all, just a tiny amount on the end of the brush is all I need really. Then onto my orc, and here what I'm doing here is I'm just applying it onto those areas I mentioned. So picking out his nails here, for example, we've got on the end of his claws, just picking out those carefully like that. There we go. I'm also going to find any screens on the model. There's one just here at the back, so I'll pick that out right now as well. And also any lenses. I've got one on the end of the shooter here. I'll pick that out too. And once I've done all of these, I'll paint the rim of the base with steel leaf and drab. And there we go. With the base rim painted, our Orc Commando knob is complete. So our Orc Commando knob is battle ready. Don't forget, you can use these same techniques to paint the rest of the members of his squad. So there's a couple of things to remember when painting your Orc Commandos. First of all, when you're applying your base coat, it's important to take your time and try and be as neat as you possibly can. Don't worry if you make a mistake, you can always go back later on and correct them. Second of all, when you're applying that Agrax Earthshade wash all over those areas at the end, make sure you don't hit that flesh. I know I've said it before, but just make sure you don't. You want to keep that flesh nice and green. Well, hope you enjoyed this video. Happy painting!